Sealions. And as the name does suggest, you can of course find the largest population of this particular type of sea lion all along the coast of California. But you can also find them as far north as Canada, where it does get really very cold. And as far south as Mexico, where of course it is lovely and warm. So these are quite a versatile, wide-ranging species. Which does also mean that they can cope with whatever the British weather has to chuckle them to, so that's always helpful. Now these two, they're not fully grown, not even this big fella here. They don't become fully grown until they're around 18 years old. By that time, they can both reach lengths of up to 2.5 metres. So they're both going to get a bit taller, especially these little fellas. But they can also end up weighing anything between 30 to possibly even 40 stone. So they're both going to get a lot fatter and a lot heavier too. To give you an idea of just how big that is, this big chap here, he nearly weighs 20 stone already. So he could potentially double in size. They can get quite big. Well, let me introduce you to the pair of them first, so you know who we're talking about. We'll start with the little man. This is Roger, and Roger is one of our babies. He's only 6 years old. So he is one of the youngest and cutest, aren't you? And he is very, very clever, but also very friendly. He loves a little flipper shake and even a kiss as well. Thank you, Roger. Now, the very noisy, excitable sea lion that sits on my left. This is Arthur. And Arthur is 15 years old now. And out of the 4 sea lions that we look after here in Knowsley, Arthur is without a doubt the naughtiest. He's really, really cheeky, causes a lot of trouble, and he makes an awful lot of noise if you haven't gathered that already. But he is very, very clever too, and also very friendly. So I'll just say a quick hello to him as well. Are you alright, Arthur? You're a beautiful boy for me today. Oh, you are, are you? Well, he always says that, so we'll soon find out. So that's our two lovely boys. We are going to start off by getting the boys to show you something which sea lions are famous for. And that is, of course, their ability to balance things on the end of their nose. Now, a lot of people know sea lions can balance, but not everyone knows how it's done. So, Roger, will you show everyone for me? Very good. So, as Roger's showing you here, the secret to it is in the lovely whiskers you can see on their faces. Now, those whiskers, they're not strong enough to hold the football up or move it around in any way, but they are very, very sensitive, so they feel for movement. So, Roger, they were feeling for movement. So Roger has to listen to those whiskers and then he moves that end of his round in the right direction with that long flexible neck to try and stop the football from falling out. So if Roger listens carefully to his whiskers, he really will balance all day long. Very well done, really. Now in the wild, of course, those whiskers, they do have a much more important use, and that is to help them find their food. So these guys, they live off fish and squid, which make an awful lot of movement. So those whiskers, they feel for the movement and vibrations that are made underneath the water. And listening to that helps them pinpoint exactly where the fish and squid are hiding. So those whiskers, they really are very important when it comes to sea lions finding their dinner. Well, do you want a big round of applause? That's a very good start. Now, when I introduced these two to you, I did introduce them as sea lions because they're not seals. People call them seals all the time, but it is true. They're in fact two completely different species. To be fair, they do look very similar. So between the three of us today, we're going to show you how you can tell the two apart. The first thing to look for is how they swim through the water. So sea lions, for instance, they only ever swim using their massive, big front flippers. Boys, show everyone how big your front flippers are for me. Here we go, thanks George, thanks all. So as you can see, these guys have huge front flippers, just like paddles. And they move them up and down in the water in almost like a flying motion. And this can propel them at speeds of anything up to about 20 miles an hour. So they can swim. Excuse me, I'm going to show them right there. They can swim pretty quickly. Now, if these guys were seals, their front flippers would be tiny. Similar size to our hands. And they'd be stuck to the sides of their bodies, making them pretty difficult to swim with. So seals, on the other hand, they use their back flipper to swim with instead. And they move that back flipper from side to side, a bit like a fish. But because these guys use those front flippers for swimming, it does mean they build up lots of muscles in their chest and in their shoulders as well, which does make them very good at things like gymnastics. Well, I'll show you what a front flipper stands for me. Get your balance, that's it. Yeah, there we go. It's impressive, isn't it? So this is something only a sea lion can do. A seal can't do this because those tiny front flippers just want to support all that weight. And remember, he is pushing nearly 20 stones onto those flippers. Now we've also been trying to teach little Roger how to do the front flipper stand. He isn't quite as good as Arthur. He almost looks like he's doing press-ups because his little one goes up and down furiously. Go on, Roger, do you want to show everyone how yours is coming along? Yeah, there we go. So with a bit of time and a bit of practice, eventually Roger will be able to hop his pump up in the air for just as long as hard. A good attempt. Give yourself a little clap. Well done, Roger. Now, because of those differences, because of those differences in the flipper sizes and of course the swimming, this also means that seals and sea lions move very differently on land as well, which is another great way to tell the two apart. So firstly, I'm going to take Arthur for a little walk around, just so you can see how he gets about when he's not in the water. So come on, I'll come up here for me. So sea lions, they can rotate their back flippers forwards or backwards. So at the minute they're out behind him because he's pretty relaxed. The minute we start walking, they rotate forward to form a pair of feet. So as Arthur walks, all four of his flippers move independently. So he walks very similar to a cat or a dog or any other four-legged animal, or at least he did. This also means he's very mobile. Arthur can jump over things, not very gracefully. And he can also jump up to try and reach things and stand up on those back flippers instead. Pretty good. Now, seals on the other hand, they do move very, very differently on land, don't they, Arthur? So these guys, they're great at doing the odd impression. So Arthur's going to have me show you how a seal gets about on land instead. What does a seal do, Arthur? Yeah, that's it. So seals, they jiggle around on their bellies and they look like giant slugs. And this is because of these tiny front flippers. They can't use them in the same way for walking or running. So sea lions will always be much more mobile if you ever see them out on the beach. It's a very good impression, Arthur. Well done, you. Oh, hello. I think he wants to show you his seal impression too. Go on, Rod, show everyone how good yours is. Yeah, very good. You can make a little round of applause. Very good impression for you. Well done. Now, with all those differences between seals and sea lions, there are, of course, a few things that they do share in common as well. The first thing and most important thing is their food. Their daily diet of fish and squid. Now, fish and squid, they're not easy things to catch. While they use their whiskers to locate where they are, they've also got to have a good sense of speed and direction. Now obviously here at Knowsley we feed these guys, so to show you how good they are at catching things, I'm going to throw these 5 rings to Roger. Let's see how many he can catch over his little head. Are you ready, Rog? There's 1, well done. 2, 3, 4, very good. So they are pretty easy, so we're going to spin the last one. Makes it a lot faster and harder for Roger to catch. Are you ready, Roger? Here it comes. Very good. So I'm going to throw these five rings again to little Roger, but this time in the water. And let's see if he can do just as well when he's swimming after them. It'll just show you how fast these guys can be. Are you ready, Roger? There's one, well done. Two, three, four, and there's five. Very well done, Roger. Very fast. The first one is the killer whale called the orca, that's its proper name. And I'm not going to tell you the second one because Arthur does a brilliant impression of that as well. So Arthur, when you're ready, you get back in position for me. There's your boy. Go on Arthur, you show everyone. What is your deadliest enemy in the wild? Yeah, he's got it, sharks. So we're talking about big sharks, tiger sharks, bull sharks. Yeah, so tiger sharks, bull sharks, and the great white. They all think sea lions make a pretty lovely dinner. Just cut into the end. Go on, show everyone how good your sharks are. Yeah, that's it. So sharks think sea lions make a pretty lovely dinner. So when these guys think of enemies close by, they swim straight back to the land where they are, of course, nice and safe. But do give up a little round of applause. We got there in the end. That was a very good start impression. Now, we are unfortunately coming quite close to the end of this afternoon's display. But before we go, I am going to let the boys finish things off with their favourite bit. And this is where they both get to do a bit of showing off. By leaping out of the water to try and touch that big ball that's all the way up there at the minute. Now, it is behind where it is. I'm going to lower it down and little Roger is going first. And at the minute, Roger can hit the high ball. Oh no, Roger, is that good for you? Yeah. But all we want him to do is touch it with his nose. But Roger, in a bit of a daredevil, you see, he likes to start his high ball attempt from up there on top of his tower. So in a minute, you're going to see him climb the stage. You can see over there, once he's at the top, he'll dive off into the water and jump up to try and hit that big ball with his nose. And of course, if he manages it, you guys have got to give him a big round of applause because he's never so good. And this takes loads of effort this jump as well. So go on, Roger, you bring yourself into position. Try and have a look at how quickly Roger can climb those stairs. Just shows you how mobile these guys are. Here we go. Keep your way to the music. Yeah. So it is Noisy's turn next, and that jump is a little bit too easy for him, so I'm going to raise it up. But before I do that, it does give me a quick chance to tell you about our posters. So at the end of the display, we'll be selling posters of Arthur and Roger. I'll be selling them from the green poster shop just over there. We'll also be selling them from under Roger's tower over there. They're only £1.50, so if you'd like to take a picture of your favourite sea lion home, do come and see us at the end. Roger's poster is ever so cute. He looks very cute, very cuddly, don't you? Arthur's poster, on the other hand, is very, very cheeky, isn't it? You're going to show him what we are. Look, what happens when we try and point the camera at you? Say cheese! He's very cheeky, isn't he? So if you would like a poster, do come and see us at the end. If you don't want a poster, that's fine. You might like to help us out with our charity instead. We're raising money for the Monk Seal Conservation Trust because the monk seal is one of the most endangered marine mammals in the world, so we're trying to do our bit to help. So if you would like to make a donation, we're collecting in a big plastic sea lion home, those exit doors, and the little plastic sealant by their closing doors. And any change that goes into there goes straight to the charity. But we haven't finished yet, it's Knowsley's turn, and he is brilliant at this. All the time goes all the way to about there for him. And again, all we want him to do is to chip in his nose. So if all the managers it, you guys have got to give him a big round of applause too. Because Arthur does have the advantage of jumping off the tower. He's going to be starting his time all the time, so I'm just going there by the new bit of stage. So this takes the most effort of all. Well, then I'll put these over here. Which also reminds me, bigger sea lion, bigger splash for you guys out there. So we always give Arthur to the count of three. You've all got to help me count, okay? The louder we do it, the better Arthur does. So you're all going to count 1, 2, 3, and then shout go. Are we ready?
1, 2, 3, 4!
He's away, will you hit it?
Yes!
Welcome, Lee. That's a delicate one. Come on, Arthur, give yourself a big clap. That was very good. Welcome, boys. So unfortunately, that does nearly bring us to the end of this display. But please stay in your seats. I can't open the doors until I've said the final little bit of health and safety. So please stay where you are just for 1 more minute. Firstly, these two, they're going to be staying in here for a little while having a swim. You're more than welcome to stop back and watch them swimming. But if you do come down to this glass barrier at the front, you must keep your hands behind it, okay? As lovely as these two are, they've both got teeth, they both bite. Please keep your hands well away and watch your children's hands as well. Also, when you're leaving the seating area, remember what I said, please don't pipe down the benches. We had a lady try and take a shortcut to a very serious accident. Please take your time and use those stairs. Finally, if you have any questions, come and ask me. I'll be over in the shop in just a minute. I'll do my best to answer. But from cheeky little Roger, noisy Arthur and me, thank you for coming. Have a lovely day. We'll say goodbye for now. Say goodbye, boys.
Oh, take a picture.
They're all going to want to live.